Remember, she's in such fine company, but this skill is pretty awesome. German Giants.
And that skill is her very own. The ironic thing, she loses a tenth on it because she does break form.
And it hurts her score, 9-5-1-2. Still to come, Svetlana Horkina, as the uneven bars event final continues. The women's uneven bars event final continues now with Yang Yun of China. That's Ling Jia. She's coming up later in this same event, yet she's out there making this preparation of the bar as a team thing.
Well, you got to remember, these athletes, they live together, they train together, and, you know, they're probably their best friends.
Yang Yun in the all-around competition had a fall on the balance beam, came very close to medaling in the all-around if it wasn't for that fall. Told her coach she still gets teary-eyed every time she thinks about just how close she got.
Chinese have the best lines in the world on the uneven bars. Excellent toes and just complete and total extension. Look at that position right there.
Textbook form, and check out the release skills. Beautiful height, great extension right down to her toe point. Yeah. That's what it takes in event finals.
She's digging it.
And this Chinese delegation on both the men's and the women's side has overperformed.
And we have loved the enthusiasm of the Chinese gymnasts, men and women.
Beautiful extension. Skyrocketing on this release skill. You know, one of the reasons the Chinese have been more successful here, I feel, they took a lot of the pressure off the athletes. Unthinkable, but they actually skipped some workouts because they felt that the pressure was getting to them.
There's your leader, Yang Yun, 9-7-8-7. And now that's the score everyone has to chase. Here's an even different look at the teamwork. Elena Prudinova of the Russian team helping prepare the bars for Tatiana Zhaganova of the Belarus team.
You got to remember that they used to be one country, and they're very friendly, speak the same language, and their coaches were from the same system, and many of them have lifelong relationships.
Tatiana has been in this position before. Last year at the World Championships, she placed eighth in the world on uneven bars. Has a really aggressive style.
A lot of these pirouetting elements right into the release skill.
That's where they get their bonus points.
And look at that.
That was great control.
That's the goal, go right to the handstand. She probably stayed in the handstand maybe even a little too long, but this is
really impressive.
An awesome routine.
Keeping her legs glued together on all her elements. This is a nice set.
Whoa.
Yikes.
That was, I thought she was going to hit her feet on the bar there.
That handstand was amazing. It's like she hit the pause button.
A lot easier to balance when you have perfectly open shoulders like she does. Everything just kind of goes into place. You know, she's just like hanging out.
That will put Zhaganova in second place, and now Svetlana Horkina is getting serious to defend her Olympic uneven bars gold medal. Back at the women's uneven bars event finals, there are your leaders, and next up is Olga Rashapkina of Ukraine. We've talked an awful lot about gymnasts leaving home, and many people who believe in the nuclear family in the United States don't understand it. In the case of Olga Rashapkina, both of her parents right now, tough times in their country. They live in a small village south of Kiev. They're unemployed. They sell what they can on the streets. Dairy products they collect somehow just to make ends meet. So gymnastics has meant a chance for her to see the world, things she never would had she not taken up the sport.
Olga is actually known to many of her gymnastic friends as the Little Lilia, of course referring to Lilia Pokopaeva, who was the 96 all-around champion. She has a bit of that same look.
And how can you not root for her to do something that could maybe change the way her family lives?
She's going to have to be absolutely perfect because she was seventh coming into these finals.
But here today, of course, best score wins. Everybody started fresh.
Dismount.
This is a big one. Oh, we know just how valuable those extra tenths are.
Had a good day in the all-around, in the top 10, placing eighth. But overall, it has been a disappointing Olympic Games for Ukraine.
Big upset by Spain, beating Ukraine out of that fifth position.
And Roshapkina's score is a 9-7-2-5. That will not be medal worthy. All right, we come down to the big moment. She started brilliantly. She hit a 9-8-5 to qualify. And then Svetlana Horkina missed twice in the team finals, in the all-around. They had the vault controversy when it wasn't high enough, and then after stumbling on the vault, she went over to the uneven bars and fell, not knowing that the vault had been wrong. This is her redemption routine.
And it is non-stop, jam-packed, original skill like that after original skill.
That's the way she envisioned it would happen in the all-around.
She can't do it any better than that.
Everyone said that if she hit tonight, this title would be hers.
Her longtime coach there, Boris Pilkin, stuck by her, she says, when everybody else gave up on her. They went back home, put in new skills like this one right there to have the opportunity to compete with the best in the world. Looks like it's paying off.
And that rhythmic clapping has been the crowd signal that they have loved what they've just seen, and they want the judges to put up a huge number. She had the highest score, remember, 9-8-5 to qualify for this event final. There it is, 9-8-6-2. That ball is out of here. But it's tough to read her reaction. The challengers that remain include her teammate, Elena Prudinova, who had her all-around opportunity snatched away because of a bad foot. Her Olympics has come down now to these event finals. And then there's Ling Jia, of whom it's said she has the best bar set in all the world. She comes out of the Chinese system, and she's built for the moment that lies ahead. Svetlana Horkina of Russia, trying to salvage a gold out of these Olympic Games. She's in the top spot. We come down to the last two in the uneven bars event finals. For Elena Prudinova, it's been a career filled with great gymnastics, but on her list of competitions is a lot of seconds, thirds, and fourths. We talked about your body doesn't know what you're putting it through, and this was one of those times when her foot didn't know that she was supposed to be in perfect health for the Olympic Games.
She had a string of fourth place finishes at last year's World Championships, one of them being on the uneven bars. She's really going to have to be exceptional if she's looking for a medal.
This is different. She does it with her legs together.
Really aggressive. Oh, and that's a major mistake there.
When she transitions from the high to the low bar, she changed the skill. All these judges know what she's supposed to do.
And you can see it in her body language.
These judges have watched her routine